Friends, we often hear about 52-week low stocks. But why 52-week low? What is so special about it? Well, the short answer is, it provides opportunity to buy great stocks at low price when they have corrected massively. So the question comes, how to identify these great stocks at 52-week low price to maximize rewards? I will talk about all of this today with practical examples of three popular stocks at 52-week low that sometime back were multi-bagger stocks, but now they are beaten down badly. And people want to know, are these stocks ready to become multi-baggers again or not? I'm sure you will learn a lot from this video, so do watch till end. Let's get started. Please note, this video is not a recommendation or advice of any kind. The stocks being discussed in the video are just for examples for learning purpose, so make sure to do your own research. So friends, why we specifically talk about 52-week low or high is that in a year there are roughly 52 weeks. So it basically gives an idea ki ek saal mein stock ne kya high banaya and kya low banaya. In this video, I'm going to discuss three 52-week low stocks. But before that, let me quickly give you an idea when to look for 52-week high stocks and when to look for 52-week low stocks. So go to Google and search 52-week low NSE. Then on this NSE's website, you can see all the stocks that made 52-week low and 52-week high today. Now, 52-week high stocks are the ones that are showing positive momentum, that is, they are in bullish trend. Whereas 52-week low stocks are the ones that have shown price correction and they are in bearish trend. That is, their price is falling. Now, you might think that if the price is falling, then why should I even consider buying stocks near 52-week low? Well, that's because the strategy for short-term trade and long-term investment are opposite. See, short-term traders look for positive momentum in their stocks. So they need to look for 52-week high stocks. Along with this, they need to check indicators like volume, look for breakout, and accordingly, they can take a long trade for booking short-term profit. I also use this three-step method for swing trading. You can learn it from the video in the I button. On the other hand, the opposite is done by long-term investors. They buy stocks at 52-week low and sell at 52-week high. Here, the idea is to invest in fundamentally strong stocks that have corrected only due to some temporary reason. But yahan par ye risk hai ke stock ko 52-week low par buy karne ke baad stock price aur bhi niche gir sakta hai. So is risk ko kaise mitigate kar sakte हैं ये भी समझेंगे आगे वीडियो में विद एग्जांपल्स. सो नाउ लेट्स एनालाइज आवर फर्स्ट स्टॉक एट 52 वीक लो, दैट इज आईडीएफसी फर्स्ट बैंक. सी ऑन स्क्रीनर वी कैन अप्लाई दिस फिल्टर, मार्केट कैपिटलाइजेशन ओवर 1000 एंड अप फ्रॉम 52 वीक लो लेस देन 10. दिस विल गिव अस स्टॉक्स दैट आर अप टू 10% अप फ्रॉम इट्स 52 वीक लो प्राइस. दिस गिव मी 67 स्टॉक्स. Now, out of this, I have randomly chosen one of the very popular stocks, that is IDFC First Bank. IDFC First Bank has been in my watch list, and when I checked its technicals, I saw that it is currently trading near its 52-week low and currently showing a correction of about 25% from its top. And the plus point here is, it has retested from this strong support. So it seems like the stock has bottomed out, which means now it's the time to analyze the stock's fundamentals to check if it's worth investing. Now, if we compare the latest quarterly result of just top line and bottom line of all of these banks, then we can see that most banks, especially banks like HDFC, Kotak, has shown very good growth in its revenue and net profit. On the other hand, IDFC First Bank has given 27.95% growth in revenue on year-on-year basis, which is good, but there is a degrowth in its net profit. In fact, gross NPA and NPA has also increased, which means not just profitability, the asset quality is also declined. But does that mean it's a bad stock, let's go buy HDFC? Well, wait. We need to set our expectations right. See, for disclosure purpose, I'm letting you know that I'm still holding HDFC because not a recommendation, just in my personal view, HDFC, in fact, other private banks like Kotak, ICICI, Axis, they still has potential to give us a good run-up. But does that mean HDFC can 3x, 5x in the next 2-3 years? Well, that is not so likely because it is too big with a market cap of over 12 lakh crores. On the other hand, IDFC First Bank is a mid-sized bank with only 56,000 crore market cap, so it can easily grow 2x if there is no major fundamental issue. So we need to dig deep and find out whether the issues in IDFC Bank are temporary or not. So let's try to find out why did the NPA increase and net profit declined. So IDFC First Bank has a type of loan called JLG, Joint Group Liability. It constitutes 6% of the total loan book of IDFC First. Now in late 2023, due to floods in Tamil Nadu, these JGL loans were impacted. So firstly, this contributed in increased NPA of IDFC First. And secondly, due to this, IDFC First had to increase their provisions, which impacted their net profit. See, net interest income increased 25% year on year. The pre-provisioning operating profit also increased 25% year on year. But here we can see that the provisions were increased from 476 to 994. This major increase in provisions impacted the net profit. That's why we can see a degrowth of 11% in net profit. And of course, it impacted its ROE and ROA also. But we all know this flood-related issue is temporary. And apart from this, the rest of the business and fundamentals are looking fine as of now. The bank has been performing in line with the growth guidance given. In fact, this stock has a plus point. The whole banking industry is struggling with deposits growth. The average year-on-year deposits growth across the industry is about only 12%. But IDFC First deposit grew 38% year-on-year. This shows that IDFC First does not have a problem growing its deposit, which is great. If we quickly look at shareholding pattern, then FIIs have been seeing selling their stake in this stock, but DIIs have been buying this stock constantly since the last 3 quarters. But what about valuation? Well, if a stock is at 52-week low, it does not mean it's undervalued. And right now in the market, I would stay away from overvalued stocks. So if we check its stock PE, then it is 19.8, which seems okay. And it is below its 5-year median PE also. But yes, it is a little over the average industry PE. But the price to book ratio is almost the same as the industry average. So valuation seems fine. But yes, we have to be very careful about this support level of 70. If this support breaks, then we can see more price correction. But currently, it has beautifully bounced back from the support. So I share the details of this stock. But to buy this stock or not is your decision. So do your own research for sure. Do note an important thing in case of 52-week low stocks. In case of these stocks, I wouldn't do a lump sum. For risk mitigation, the ideal way would be buy this stock at different price levels. Do keep in mind. Now let's analyze another popular stock at 52-week low, Happiest Minds. Friends, if you're new to the channel, please make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the like button if you like the video. See, if we look at its monthly chart, we can see that since December 2020, this stock has given a huge rally of over 400%. So Happiest Minds was a good business and was a multi-bagger stock. So what happened now? See, this was a massive run-up. The valuation reached from 21 to 144, means the valuations went ahead of its earnings. Thus, the stock price was bound to fall. And currently, we can see a correction of about 50% from its top in this stock. Now, this stock has been in bearish trend since the last 3 years. But now, it is trading at strong support range and it seems to be in its last phase of consolidation. In fact, some brokers even gave a short-term target price of 834. But the question is, has the time arrived to start accumulating this stock in SIP mode? Well, I can't answer you that. What I can do is analyze the stock and highlight the pros and cons of the stock so that you can decide for yourself with your own research. So Happiest Minds is a 12,000 crore IT company. And in the latest quarter result, we saw that the revenue grew 18.7% year on year and 11.2% quarter on quarter. Well, in last quarter, Happiest Minds acquired two companies, PureSoft Technologies and Aurus Tech Systems. And a part of this 11.2% growth in quarter-on-quarter revenue was contributed by these two acquired companies, which means that the growth that we are seeing right now is not fully organic. Also, we can see some negative growth in certain segments like travel, manufacturing, etc. And the reason was some of the projects in these sectors were deferred. If we talk about bottom line, then we can see a decline of about 29% in net profit from 7,100 crores to 5,100 crores, which is not good. This decline in net profit has been attributed to expenditures related to the acquisitions of the two companies. Plus, there was also a write back of about 13 crores from the previous quarter. So yes, these were one-time non-recurring expenditure. But if you would read the con call, you would note that the management said that these one-time costs related with acquisitions may impact the net profits in the next 2 to 3 quarters also. So overall, we can say that the quarter one result of financial year 2025 was weak. But still, the stock is trading at a PE of 52.5. This PE is below its own historical 5-year median PE, but it is over the average industry PE of about 40. Plus, in my view, with the company still posting negative growth in net profit, the stock is overvalued at 52. And not just that. In June quarter, promoter Mr. Ashok Soota was seen selling his stake. The reason given was it was for his personal philanthropic and non-profit work, and the management promises that he's not going to sell any more stake, at least in the immediate future. But in the end, whatever the reason may be, a promoter selling 6% of his stake is not a positive sign. So does that mean there are only negatives about this company? No. Let's look at the positives. See, the two companies that they acquired are actually from good domains. PureSoft is focused on banking and financial services, and Aurus Systems on insurance. And I think that eventually they do have the potential to become growth drivers for this company. Another good thing is, in the last quarter, they launched generative AI business services. We all know this is a good sector for future growth, and this newly launched service has already contributed 1.5% in revenue in last quarter. Also, with US interest rate cut, we can also expect the global demand going up. Even the management of Happiest Mind is also hopeful that things would improve since quarter 3. Rest, if we talk about future outlook, management gave a revenue forecast of 30 to 35% in financial year 2025 and an expected EBITDA margin of 20 to 22%. Plus, the company also targets a revenue of $1 billion by financial year 31. So overall, I'm not hopeless about this stock. I'm still positive. So I'm going to monitor the progress in the coming quarters. You tell me in comments, what are you doing with this stock? Now time for another popular stock at 52 week low. It is Bajaj Finance. See, the stock PE is only 28, which is almost at the bottom of the historical 5-year PE. This stock has been posting great quarterly results with amazing growth in sales, net profit. In the last 3 years only, the revenue has more than doubled. The net profit has more than tripled. And if you would go and check the other fundamentals, they are also looking good. But the stock has given no returns since the last 3 years. So it is showing time correction. Now currently, this stock is trading about 9% up from its 52-week low price, and we can see an upside potential of about 21% to its 52-week high. Now, when RBI will cut interest rate, the stock price of Bajaj Finance may rise. But we have to remember that I said that stocks near 52-week low are not short-term play. They are mostly for long-term investment. So even if we are trying to find out undervalued and fundamentally strong stocks like Bajaj Finance, we still have to keep our investment horizon to at least 1 to 2 years. That is all for today, my friends. Make sure to do your own research. Nothing is a recommendation. For more educational content, make sure to subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon. Thanks for watching till the end.